Hello children, good morning to you all. I think your people don't know me, yes? I am Surekha teacher, right? I am your social studies and English teacher. Now you are in which class? You are in fourth class. Now you have passed third class, third standard, and now you entered into the fourth standard. So, I am your social studies and the English teacher. Understand? So, here I am going to take you a class today. Enjoy the class, all of you. Okay. So, first of all, let me introduce you the class. What will be there in my class? First, let us talk about English. And then I will talk about social studies. Right. So, first let me show you your English and social studies textbooks. When I am starting with English, this is your English textbook. This is your English textbook for fourth class. So, we are going to do the lessons from this textbook. So, if you have your brother's book or sister's book, that's good. If not, buy. Because 1 week I will teach you grammar and all. But you have to buy this book. Understand? And this book you will get from Sri Vidya bookstore. Tell your parents to buy the book. Okay? So, book you will get from Sri Vidya bookstore. Unless you have the textbook, you cannot do with any exercises or lesson reading or anything given. I will give you hard words. You have to underline the textbook, write in the notebook. For everything you need textbook. Very important for you. So you are going to buy this textbook. Second thing to tell you is, when you sit for the class, sit in a place where it is total silence. You sit in the room of your house where there is lot of silence. First thing, then always carry, you keep this textbook, notebook and a pencil. You are in fourth class, you are not supposed to use any pen for writing. That's why you are using the pencil. You are using a pencil. So, use pencil for writing. So, every day when you sit for the class, keep the textbook, plus notebook and a pencil and eraser with you. If anything I tell you to write, you are going to write in the notebook. If I ask you to open the book on so and so pages, you have to open the book on that particular page number. And you have to look into the book. If I am reading the listening zone, you have to look into the book. That's why you need a textbook. So don't forget, every day before sitting for the class, take out the textbook and sit for doing the lesson. So, buy this textbook as soon as possible. As soon as possible means as quickly as possible. Buy this book and we are going to do the lessons. And for as of now, we are doing with Grammar Park, reading and writing skills. We are going to do with writing skills. And what do you all have in English class about it we are talking. So here are some lessons and poems which we are going to deal. Understand, we are deleting few lessons and poems which I will tell you afterwards, which I will tell you after. So when I start the lesson, that day I will give you the detailed lessons names which are included in your fourth class portion. Here in the textbook we have got 11 lessons and 5 poems. But all the lessons and all the poems are not included. What lessons are included, what poems are included, I will give you an idea. Others you cross mark, which we are doing in the class, tick mark them. Understand? So when we get the textbook, we will start it. And for today, what we are doing is, we are doing with our grammar part. So we are starting our first session, first class for this year, 2021 July. Understand? What subject we are dealing with now? With the English. Subject we are taking English. Okay. So, what we are going to learn? First, you all know how to write ABCD, everything. But correct method you have to follow for it. For that purpose, let us do with writing skills. Writing and reading. For that purpose, first you will know the letters in English. 26 letters we have in English alphabet. They are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. So these are total 26 letters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, and 26. This is how you have got 26 letters in English. Out of these 26, 5 letters are vowels. Well, I think last year you learnt those 5 letters which are vowels are, I write on it V, A, E, I, O, U. These are the vowels. Understand? How many letters in this set are vowels? A, E, I, O, U. And remaining 21 are called consonants. Remaining 21 are called consonants. From B to Z. Excluding these 5. If 5 of these stay, 21 letters manaki consonants antamu English lo. Understand? Using these vowels and consonants, we form the words in English. Using these vowels and consonants only, we form the words. What are these vowels for? They give sound to the word. They give sound to the word. Without vowels, we cannot write any word. If vowels are not there, no word is built. If we take out these, A, E, I, O, U, only we have B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. Excluding these 5, if you read only these 21 letters, you cannot make any word using these 21 letters. For example, if I write B, T, F, L, what? Can you read it as a word? No, you cannot read. In between you need these vowel words. What are those vowels you need? This is beautiful spelling. But if I write like the BTFL, can you read it as beautiful? You cannot read it as beautiful. The reason for this is we are missing the vowels. Vowels only give sound to the word. B E A U T I F U L. B U T full. So B U T full in this way. This E A U gives the sound of B U. I gives the sound of T I T F U L. U gives the sound of full. In this way, without these letters, if we write the spelling of beautiful, we cannot have any meaning for it. That's why vowels are very, very important for us. Both only vowels if you use, you cannot make the word. For example, I O A I O E. If I write, you cannot make any word here. I O D I won't write. I O D I N E. So you need even consonants also. D and L consonants. You need both vowels and consonants to make the word. Without vowels and consonants, you cannot make any words. What the B C D F and L R S they didn't word out unda. Avadu. B T T R and te butter out unda ma. Kargada. B U T T E R. U and E use the sound for the word butter. Vowels. Our vowels lekunda manam A words raayalem. Only consonants use this. With migita లెటర్స్ యూజ్ చేసి ఈ ఫైవ్ లేకుండా మనము ఏ వర్డ్స్ కూడా రాయలేము. కాబట్టి ఓవెల్స్ మన హిందీలో స్వర అండ్ వ్యంజనమే ఉంటాయి. ఆకి మాత్ర, ఈకి మాత్ర, ఓకి మాత్ర, టకు ఆకి మాత్ర, టా ఆ అని వస్తుంది. టకు ఈకి మాత్ర టీ అని వస్తుంది. టకో బడీ ఓకి మాత్ర, సారీ టకో చోటీకి మాత్ర టీ, టకో చోటీ కి మాత్ర టూ అలా అంటాం. ఆ మాత్ర అచ్చి సౌండ్స్ ఇస్తాయి. అలాగే తెలుగులో కూడా అచ్చులు అని హల్లులు ఉంటాయి. ఆ అచ్చుల వల్ల మనకి సౌండ్స్ వస్తాయి అనమాట వర్డ్స్కి. తలకట్టు, గుడి, గుడి దీర్ఘము, కొమ్ము, కొమ్ము దీర్ఘము, ఇవన్నీ ఇస్తేనే కానీ ఏ లెటర్కైనా కవి ఇలా రాస్తే కవిత అవుతుంది. నీవు కవిత రాయాలంటే ఈ వాకి గుడి ఇస్తే వి అవుతుంది. కావలి రాయాలి, క వల్ల రాస్తాను. ఇప్పుడు కాకి దీర్ఘం ఇస్తే కా వా కుతలకట్టు, లా గుడి ఇస్తే వి, అప్పుడే అది కావలి అవుతుంది. ఈవెన్ తెలుగులో కూడా ఇవి సౌండ్స్ అనమాట. ఇది తలకట్టు, దీర్ఘము, గుడి దీర్ఘము, అన్ని కొమ్ములు అన్ని ఇస్తాం కదా, వాటి వల్లనే మనకి వర్డ్స్కి సౌండ్ వస్తుంది. అదేవిధంగా ఇంగ్లీష్లో ఓవెల్స్ వల్లనే వర్డ్స్కి సౌండ్ వస్తుంది. ఒట్టి కాన్సనెంట్స్ యూజ్ వర్డ్ చేయలేము, ఒట్టి ఓవెల్స్ యూజ్ చేసి కూడా వర్డ్స్ చేయలేము. రెండుకు మిక్స్ చేస్తేనే మనకి వర్డ్స్ వస్తాయి అన్నమాట. అండర్స్టాండ్? దిస్ ఈజ్ వన్ సెట్ ఆఫ్ క్వశ్చన్ ఫర్ యూ, ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ ఫర్ యూ. Now, we learnt about the letters. We learnt about the letters. So, next thing to learn is letters over, words and sentences. To talk or to write, we need words and sentences. Just now I showed you. ఎల్ఎల్ అని రాస్తే టాల్ అవుతుందా మనకి? కాదు. ఇక్కడ ఈ టీ మరి ఎల్ఎల్ మధ్యలో ఏ రాస్తేనే టాల్ అనే స్పెల్లింగ్ వస్తుంది. అవునా? ఇదే స్పెల్లింగ్ నేను ఇలా రాస్తాను. ALTL సేమ్ ఉన్నాయి లెటర్స్ కానీ ఇది వర్డ్ మనం దీనిలో నుంచి మీరు చదవగలుగుతారా తొందరగా వర్డ్ నో వై దీస్ లెటర్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ అరేంజ్డ్ ఇన్ ఏ కరెక్ట్ ఆర్డర్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ అరేంజ్డ్ ఇన్ ఏ కరెక్ట్ ఆర్డర్ ఫర్ మేకింగ్ ద వర్డ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు అరేంజ్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్ ఇన్ ఏ కరెక్ట్ ఆర్డర్ వేర్ టు రైట్ టి ఫస్ట్ టి షుడ్ కమ్ దెన్ టు గెట్ ద సౌండ్ నెక్స్ట్ ఏ షుడ్ కమ్ దెన్ లాస్ట్ ఎల్ఎల్ షుడ్ కమ్ సో ఫస్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు రైట్ టి then we have to write a then we have to write ll tall what it is though vowels and consonants are written here they are not correctly arranged they are not correctly written that's why we don't get any word here to get the word what we need to arrange these letters which are which we need for the spelling in a right order next word I will take bread b r d if I write can it become bread no what is the bread spelling b r e a d bread so I write b e d a r b r e a d bread kavali aa bread ki kavali anni spellings unnai kani ikkada we cannot read it very quickly we have to arrange them they are in jumbled manner in a wrong manner written we have to write them correctly b r e a d where sound needs there only vowels should come in this way same unna ikkada b undi ikkada r undi ikkada kuda r undi e a undi last d vachindi కానీ అది ఇక్కడ కరెక్ట్గా అరేంజ్ చేసింది లేదనమాట ఇక్కడ అది కరెక్ట్గా రాసింది లేదు కాబట్టి మనకి అది కరెక్ట్ స్పెల్లింగ్ ఇవ్వదన్నమాట అందుకు బ్రెడ్ అని రాయడానికి కావాల్సిన స్పెల్లింగ్కి కావాల్సిన అన్ని లెటర్స్ ఇక్కడ ఉన్నా కూడా మనం అది రాయలేము ఎందుకంటే అవి కరెక్ట్గా చదవలేము అది బ్రెడ్ అని ఎందుకంటే అవి కరెక్ట్గా రాసినవి లేవు అక్కడ అవి కరెక్ట్గా రాసినవి లేవు కాబట్టి మనము చదవలేము అన్నమాట Understand. Ippudu peacock. P C K C. Ante peacock avutundamma? Kani peacock ki spelling emundi P A C O C K. Peacock undi. Ippudu nenu rastanu. P O C A E K C. Ante peacock spelling vastunda? Raadu. ఇదంతా స్పెల్లింగ్ పికాక్ లో పికాక్ రాయడానికి కావాల్సిన లెటర్స్ అన్ని ఇక్కడ ఉన్నాయి పి ఉంది ఈఏ సిఓ సికే పికాక్ సేమ్ లెటర్స్ మనం ఇక్కడ కరెక్ట్ చదవలేము పికాక్ అని కరెక్ట్ రాయలేము వాట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ అరేంజ్డ్ ఇన్ ఎ కరెక్ట్ మేనర్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ అరేంజ్డ్ ఇన్ ఎ కరెక్ట్ మేనర్ సో వి కెనాట్ రీడ్ దెమ్ we cannot read them that's why we cannot read it exactly as peacock so same letters if we arrange them in a correct order in a correct manner then only we can read it as peacock understand unless we write it in a correct manner we can't read it as peacock so now easily we can make out it is peacock because all the letters in it are written in a correct order that is how what are words words are set of letters or group of letters but in which way what letters arranged in a correct manner words are the set of letters arranged in a correct manner if you don't arrange them in a correct manner they cannot be read as word here we arranged it in a correct manner bread we arranged tall we arranged peacock we arranged in correct manners all the spellings then only we can read here jumbled way you got in all the three cases can you read we cannot read these all in jumbled manner or incorrect manner we can't read them correctly, or we cannot even, unless we read, we cannot write. First thing comes reading, then only writing. If you read correctly, then only you are able to write it correctly. For that purpose, we have to arrange the words in a correct way. To get the spelling of the word, we have to arrange the letters in a correct way. We have first got the letters in English alphabet, they are 26. Out of 26, 5 are vowels and remaining A, E, I, O, U, all the 5. A, E, I, O, U. These 5 are vowels. And remaining 21, B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. They are consonants. So, without consonants, we can't make words. Without vowels, we can't make words. Both we have to mix. And take istamochina to mix cheyadam kadu. We have to mix them in a correct order. Then only we can make the words. We can arrange the words in correct order. We can arrange the words in correct order. When all the letters are written in a correct order, then only it gives a word. So, to make any sentence, words are very important for us. First of all, we have to learn to write the words correctly. Then only we can write the sentences. So, first we have to learn to write the words correctly. How to write the words correctly? We have to arrange the letters which we need for the spelling of any word in a correct order, then only we can write that word correctly. Sometimes teacher gives you in dictation, but you will get some correctly, some wrongly. Which have become correct? Which you arranged the spelling, or which you wrote all the letters in that word in a correct order, then only you get correct word. Why you get wrong? Because you arrange the words in a wrong manner, so the word becomes wrong. Or else you skip any letter from the word. If it's beautiful only, B-E-U-T-I or B-E-A-T-I-F-U-L any rastar. Madhyalo U tinestaram mata. Ala, edaina skip chesina word raadu, meer correct ga arrange cheyakapoyina word raadu. Word raayalante, we have to arrange the letters in a correct order. That is the most important thing we have to know about any word. So, for writing the sentence, we need a word which has correct spelling. So, words and sentences are very important for us to make the sentence. To read or write or speak, we need the sentences. Okay. To you need the sentences means what you have to do? You have to speak a sentence. Now I am teaching you. I said I am teaching you. This is a complete sentence. I am teaching you English. It is a complete sentence. I English, you teach. If I say, it becomes wrong, you start laughing. So words should be arranged very correctly in the group sentence. What is sentence? A group of letters arranged in a right manner. What are words? Words are also a group of letters arranged in a correct manner. If you don't arrange them correctly, you cannot make them as words. Understand? So, to make the sentences, it is very important for us to write the spellings correctly. To write the spellings correctly. Unless we write the spelling correctly, our word cannot become correct. So that's why you get wrongs when teacher gives you dictation. For that purpose, what you must do? You have to learn the spellings correctly, and while writing, you have to arrange the spellings in a right manner. Then only you are able to write the words correctly. Words and sentences are very important for us to speak, read or write anything. Any language you take, your mother tongue or Hindi or even English, whatever you use, you are learning science, maths, social studies, English, and computers in English language. So it is very important for us to know the language correctly. What is a language? The sentences put together to express our ideas is called a sentence. What is a sentence? It is a group of words which are arranged in a right manner, not ulta pulta. That's why arranging the letters correctly in the words is very important. Same way, arranging the words in a sentence also is very important. So, sentence is a group of words arranged in a right manner. What are words? Words are the group of letters arranged in a right manner. If you don't arrange them in a right manner, they are wrong words, or we can call them jumbled words. So, this is the topic we dealt today. I am going to give you one small, piece of test work, homework, in which I will give five words without vowels. You have to insert, put in between vowels and make the words. 5 to 10 I give jumbled words. You have to write them correctly. And first A to Z neatly you write in your notebook. This is what for today. Thank you so much, children. Thank you.